In this video, we'll look at camera framing and staging in 3ds Max. In the previous lesson on camera animation, we had put a camera in the view and started out looking through the windows, then panned to the side and dollied back a little bit to reveal Tuiko standing and talking in the middle of the lobby of the new education building. The next camera from this, logically, might be a closer-in shot on them. Ideally, as part of this view, one of the eco will turn and look towards us, or maybe turn and gesture out the window. They're letting us know about something going on here. I'll get a new camera in, and plan to overlap the time a little bit, so the animation is done once and viewed twice. I'll start out by increasing the time. I'll go into the time configuration, and I'm going to give myself, oh, I don't know, here's 240 frames, 10 seconds at 24 frames per second. Now, my first camera animation stops at 96. In 3ds Max, you're perfectly okay to overlap cameras on a timeline. They don't have to be in sequence. That way you can have multiple cameras showing the same animation from different views. To make a new camera then, I'll go in a front view and start out. Or maybe in a left view by hitting L. The reason I'm switching to an upright view, such as front or left, is so that when I make the camera, it doesn't aim down to the floor. I'll use a free camera for this one. I'll press W for move, and I'll get the camera close in on the characters. Hitting C for camera will take me to the selected camera. Okay, here I am in realistic mode. I've also added a daylight system in, not necessarily the exact lighting for the space, but as it does display in the realistic view, it gives me a pretty good idea of the lighting and shadow going on in the scene. What I'll start out with then is panning the camera up and dolly in to focus on the ecos. I'll make sure that my render setup is set using HDTV, my aspect for this movie, so that when I press Shift F for the safe frame, I see everybody correctly framed. This is not a bad shot, but it's kind of out there a little bit. It's leaving a lot of space around. Being that I just used an establishing shot, or a long shot, to introduce the scene in the previous camera, this one might be better off as a medium shot, roughly torso up, or in the case of the eco, well, it's most of the body because they're kind of short. Let's say that we're going to look at this one, and he's going to gesture out the window at the deck. First off in the camera, once I've established how much of the character is shown, I need to watch out for framing and tangents. He's pretty good here. He's on the third line of the image, one-third, two-thirds, and his eyes are on the horizontal third line. That's good. However, if we go into a wireframe, we can really see this. He has the top of a column sticking out from his head. There's a couple approaches to this. I could orbit the camera around, looking a little more straight at him, and placing the column behind him, giving him places where he sticks out from the line of the column, and we notice his hands. I can go in a little closer on his face as well, maybe even switching lenses. I'll go over to a 35, and that way it flattens out the depth. I'll go fairly close on him, still a medium shot, and he's set to gesture out the window, at which point this camera will follow the eye line out to look at something. Being that the first camera went to frame 96 and got us pretty close in to set the stage for their discussion, this next camera should catch the end of that movement. I'm going to guess at the moment and start the animation at 72. I can always use the range bars down here on the timeline to move an animation around if I need. I'll hit N for auto key, make sure the camera is selected so I don't accidentally key another object, and I may also want to turn on my selection filter for cameras. Now, auto key is going to give me a key at 0 and 72. There's a couple of ways around this. I could use set key instead, where I go to a frame and hit key to set a key at that frame, in this case a move, rotate, and scale key. This may be a better approach for this camera, so I don't have an extra keyframe always to delete. I'll go over maybe 3 seconds. How about 144? And anticipate following his eye line out. I'll click on the orbit tool, orbit the camera holding shift to constrain the direction, and pan back over. We'll follow his eye line and arm line pointing out to look at the deck. And I'll hit the key button to set another key. Let's see if this works. We start close in, we're going to watch his arm pointing out, and as his arm points out, the camera goes and looks out the window. Not a bad shot, maybe needs a little more tweaking. I've landed a large window frame right in the lens. What I'll do is I'll go back to that frame at 144 and just orbit that camera over a little bit more to follow him and look out the window. And I'll hit the key button to set a key again. You can use auto key or set key to animate. It really doesn't matter. It's whatever you're comfortable with. A lot of character animators prefer set key, as it allows them to get the character in a pose, which we'll cover in the next lessons, versus auto key puts keyframes at zero automatically and at the frame you're on. We go, we follow his eyeline, we look out the window, and this rock, framed in this window frame, draws our eye out into that view. That's a pretty good shot. As always, I'll go into the track view and make sure that my keyframes are eased. I'll zoom in, and there's the camera's position and rotation and scale. I don't really need a scale key necessarily, so I could take it off if I wanted, or just leave it alone. But I'll pick the position keys and just check their tangents, making sure that they're nice and smooth. This looks pretty good. I'll play it. And in this case, I'm just going to start, I'm going to let it play, and judge that motion. Okay. It's working. I realize we're leaving some up to the imagination in terms of his arm animation, but we want to get the cameras pretty well blocked in and framed so we can animate to them. If we need to tweak the camera animation later, it's not a big deal, but we don't want to start from nothing and try to animate a character and make it look right and then figure out how to show it.